Welcome back to Dark Souls 3. Let's go do some dancing. Yes, I actually dodged the freaking... Was that a spear or a halberd? Whatever that person is, I always get hit by that. And this time I didn't. Bad timing. Also bad timing. Good timing. Turn the dancer's butt into a pincushion. I'm gonna poke it full of holes. Poke, poke, poke. Damn it! Okay, that was my warm-up. I got this. Pincushion. Poke that butt. Oh no. I shouldn't have backed myself into a corner. It's really best to just get away when they're doing that attack. Uh-oh. That was a bad sign. Okay, runaway time. Jesus. Thinking maybe, yeah, you know what, I should be using embers. I'm not sure why I wasn't, I just didn't even think about it. Also, possibly I should be using something on my weapon that increases damage. What would it be vulnerable to? I have no idea. It uses fire attacks sometimes and dark attacks, so I imagine electricity probably wouldn't be something it's vulnerable to. Or, I mean, fire wouldn't be something it's vulnerable to, or dark. Maybe lightning? I, like, never use these, but I barely have any of them, really. They're quite rare. I don't think I'm gonna use it. I don't feel like I should use it on such a boss. I mean, it's not that it's an easy boss. Obviously, I've died enough to it that it's obviously not. But it's definitely not a super difficult boss. And given how rare they are, I think I'll save it. But I'll definitely use embers. See that coming. Wait, what am I doing? Run! Run, you fool! Whew. Damn it. Does it have a third form? Something changing? Doesn't look different so far. Okay, almost got it. Just gonna preemptively heal. Damn it. It wasn't a super hard fight, but yeah, I think that was a really good challenge. Like, the perfect difficulty. And a beautiful boss, too. So elegant in his movements. Go spend these souls, see what I can soul transpose with the soul as well.
Aha, so happened upon a
so there's a spell. Dancer's enchanted swords. Curved swords. Paired. So I could dual wield them. Anything else? Nope. Okay. So let's see. Paired enchanted swords that Pontiff Sullivan bestowed upon the Dancer of the Boreal Valley. These blades, symbolic of the Dancer's vows, are enchanted by dark magic in the right hand and fire in the left, mirroring the Pontiff. Dancer's Grace is the skill. Unleash the Fury of both blades in a dancing spin motion and use Strong Attack to continue the performance until stamina is exhausted. That sounds super cool. It's also interesting that it has, well, three different kinds of damage. Physical damage, magic, and fire, depending on whether you're hitting with the right or left weapon. And it is a dexterity-based weapon. It fits me. Scaling's not great, though. Descaling in both dexterity and strength. Not the best. But it's very interesting. And heck, it doesn't cost anything to do it, so I'm gonna go with it.
No.
I wanna see what they look like in action. And see how the stats compare. So, physical damage obviously does way less. And yeah, I get way, way less from the scaling as well. Instead of B scaling, I have D. Terrible. But I get magic and fire damage. Let's try him out. That is gorgeous looking. Okay, so let's actually do that. That was just the normal attack where it just uses the right blade. Let's actually do the dual wielding attacks. So that's the fast attacks. Very cool. A good burst of attacks. It's not super fast, though. Like, there's a lot of attacks happening during the attack. The actual time for each attack is actually kind of long. Strong attack. Wait, Wait, is that the strong attack? No, it's not the strong attack. That's the special attack. I guess there really is... I guess there really is no actual dual-wielding strong attack that actually utilizes the dual-wield properties. I could do a strong attack, but once again, it just uses the right blade. So I think I can only do fast attacks or the special attack. Now, what did it say? What did it say? Use strong attack to continue the performance until stamina is exhausted. Okay, so I think I can chain it. Let's try that. Is that what they mean? It doesn't look like I'm doing anything special. It just looks like I'm chaining multiple of them back to back. Oh, there we go. There we go. That was cool. Okay, so yeah, you have to use the left trigger to start doing it. And then you have to keep pressing the strong attack on the right trigger, which normally only uses the right sword and doesn't do any sort of a dual-wieldy thing, but if you're in this mode, then it does do a dual-wieldy thing. Let's do that again. Let's get my FP up there again. Does it continue to drain FP? It does. That is so fucking cool! Oh my god. And you can do that even without the FP, it does less damage, I imagine. That is so freaking cool! I want to test that out on some, like, junky enemies that aren't too hard. But that puts me overweight, right? Yeah, because it's heavier. So that actually puts me overweight, but I think if I take off that, then I'm underweight, yeah. Alright, let's go test that out on something. In fact, I know exactly what to test it out on. It's not really a junky enemy, but... this will fit my purposes because I'm going to do something else just after fighting this enemy, which I'll tell you about in a minute. And Orlando... There you are. Alright, let's try this out. Damn it, don't interrupt me, asshole! I was hoping it would stun them. I'm trying to be fancy here, come on. That did not do much damage because of the shield, but that looks so cool! Ow. Alright, let's just try doing normal dual-wield attacks. Stop it! Meanie. Now that's much better at stunning. Yeah, look at how much damage that does. It does like no damage. But then again, was it doing no damage because I was out of FP? Let's test that. How much damage did it do initially? I'm pretty sure these are just very bad in terms of damage. But but I still want to test it, because, god, they're cool. Yeah, but it does like no damage, even with FP. Oh my god, why is this so bad? For how cool it looks, you'd think it'd be better. It doesn't even do a great job stunning them. This does a good job stunning them. But also just look at that damage. Like, the damage is just not very good. And I know it's not, I haven't upgraded it, but even if I upgrade it, I don't think it'd be good enough. I mean, if I go back to the S-Dog. Yeah, man. For such cool swords, they're terrible. This S-Dog is so much better. Even if I got, even if I got the swords up to plus 2, I know it'd do more damage, but I don't think it'd be enough. Ah well. Tis a shame. I would totally use those if they were actually pretty good. Because they are gorgeous. Ah, right, my torch. Okay, so I've got a little thing to do. Rather than talk about it, I'm just gonna do it. And I know I haven't spent my souls yet, don't worry. So for a while now, I've been thinking, how do I get to that bonfire? And then it hit me, like, maybe if I just think hard enough, I can just go through the air. No, I'm just kidding, it didn't just hit me. I didn't look it up on a wiki, in my defense, or anything like that, but I also didn't figure it out on my own. As a matter of fact, as strange as it sounds, I'm gonna head back and spend my souls before I explore this area. As strange as it sounds, I actually learned about that from talking to somebody on the bus. I was riding the bus, I was talking to somebody, I was talking about Dark Souls 3. We were talking about Anor Londo, and he mentioned the Invisible Bridge, and I was like, Invisible Bridge? What? And then it hit me, is that how you get to that bonfire? It turns out it is. So there you go, there's a friggin' Invisible Bridge. I should have known. Should have known, I saw the bonfire, I know Dark Souls has a history of invisible bridges. But I didn't think of it. Well, very that take. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 levels up. Let's put 2 into dexterity. 1 into endurance, 1 into vigor. And then I guess I'll put 1 into vitality so I stop scraping at the edge of 70% equipment load.
Farewell, Ash Maiden.
Also, I haven't checked how much Titanite I've gotten lately, but let me see if I have enough to upgrade this S-Dock. Nope, need 1 more Titanite chunk. She's very creepy looking. And she also makes a creepy breathing noise.
Name thyself, stranger. I am Yoshka, captain of the Dark Moon Knights. What beckoned thee to such a place? Thou thinkst too. Very well. Captain to this nightless company I remain. I will grant thee purpose. Thou'st journeyed far. Hear my voice. If thou shalt swear by the covenant to become a shadow of Father Gwyn and Sister Guinevere, a blade that shall hunt the foes of our lords, then I place thee under the aegis and the power of the Dark Moon. Thou art now a blade of the Dark Moon, the only knight of our company. Swear this oath and face thy solemn duty. Oh, good blade of the Dark Moon, welcome home. If I can provide thee succor, only tell me how. Long ago, our father Gwyn, lamenting the waning of the fire, became cinder of his own will. Now, the fire is linked by the champions who have come in his stead. Such is the will of Father and the gods. And so the Dark Moon Knights took arms to watch over those who link the fire. But long ago, our company lost its last proper knight. Only its covenant was preserved to this day, until the time of thy visit. Erdem taketh many forms, indeed. May I pose thee a question? This tower, this prison, stands tall and solitary, the contraption bridging its lower reaches long unmoving. So, by what path didst thou here ascend? Art thou a creature of the air? Or other winged thing?
I can answer. Interesting. Lying seems unwise.
No, of course not. Forgive my prying. Think no more on mine asking. I'm ashamed to say I know very little of anything. Long ago, off so soon, may the Dark Moon watch over thee.
I wonder what would have happened if I said yes. Probably nothing of significance, but still, I'm curious. I wish I could tell her that she could just leave this place. Help her leave this place somehow. Okay, I think my only way down is by falling. It would seem so. No! I want that item. I'll come back for it. Ooh. Very, very light armor. Attire of the painting guardians, whose forms are described in the mythology of heretics. Smooth, pale gown that deters magic. The hunchbacked teller of ancient tales describes unwanted souls who are unwelcome across the lands, and are eventually drawn into a cold, painted world. Ah, right, the painted world. I remember that from Dark Souls 1. Yeah, the Painted World is something you... I don't remember much about it. I just know it's a place that you enter, and that's where you fight the giant woman with a tail? Not the same giant woman I've been talking about before in Anne Orlando, but a different giant woman with a tail? I forgot her name. Let's see what the outfit looks like. That's beautiful. I'd be a little bit scared of tripping, though. If you tripped, I feel like you could impale yourself upon your own shoe tips. Uh-oh. I'm dead. Is there anything I can land on to reliably get that? No, there's no wood platform whatsoever. So I have to land on a beam. Okay. Ah! Painting Guardian's curved sword. A weapon described in legends passed down amongst heretics wielded by the Painting Guardians. A uniquely shaped weapon with a flat tip. Ooh, the skill sounds interesting. Chained dance. Execute relentless consecutive attacks while tracing a circle in a unique dance of deadly grace. It does terrible damage at the moment, but of course it isn't upgraded. And it's probably not a special weapon, so I could probably upgrade it to plus 10, just as I can with my S-Doc. So it could do pretty good damage. This is intriguing. The scaling is already B in dex. Does that mean if I use a sharp gem on it, I can make it an A scaling in dexterity? And it also has a bleeding effect. Damn. I really want to investigate this weapon, but now's not quite the time. If only I had the cat ring. Ooh, that was close. Okay, we're good. I did it. Congratulations. Woohoo! That's not the right emote. Jump, you fool. Hey! It's this place! It's this place! I remember I came to the bottom of this place and I was like, I don't know how to... There's something up there, but I don't know how to get there. So that's it to the place, I guess? Okay then. Oops. But let's go examine this weapon. I want to see if it is considered a normal weapon. I want to see if I can use a sharp gem on it and see if I can get it to plus 10. Hopefully it doesn't require twinkling titanite or anything like that. Hopefully it's considered a normal weapon, so let's go see. Also, let's just actually use the damn thing, huh? Okay, I see a big problem. It's freaking tiny. It seems like the sort of weapon you're supposed to use a shield with. It's really, really short. Okay, so that's short attack. That's strong attack. Very fast weapon. So let's check out the special attack. I'm guessing you activate it the same way as the other weapons I was just using. Let's try that. Yep. It doesn't look like it goes infinitely, though. It seems to have a pretty short limit. Yeah, that's the end of it. So it's a pretty short combo. A couple attacks and then like a big, big slice. Execute relentless consecutive attacks while tracing a circle. Does it trace a circle? I don't really see the circle. Anyway, very cool, but yeah, I don't think this weapon's anywhere near long enough for me to use effectively without using a shield, and I'm not switching to a shield. Let's see if it is considered a normal weapon. Yeah, it's a normal weapon. Uses titanite shards. So it could do pretty damn good damage, really. It's just the length, I think. I assume that also means I could change its type to sharp. Yeah, god, I can make it scaling A, which is insanely good.
Pretty, be careful. I go.
Ah, if only it was longer, though. It's just not long enough. Alright, let's go back and use the thingy at the place. Is it gonna fill up with knight's blood or something? Ew, I knew it. Three ways. I choose left. Item and an enemy down that way. Pointless dead end, indeed. Looks like at some point I can get up there and then fall down back here. So what's up ahead? This looks like a trap. Oh, no, you don't. Jesus! My souls were right there! Alright, well now I don't have to worry about them. Racing the ghost. Come on, I'm getting there first! Oh, I guess I win. Damn these red knights! What if I just ignore it? The other one. Oh, it buffs it. So this is a boss, right? Just doesn't have a health bar. No buff. Oh man, you're a lot easier when you're not buffed, huh? Yeah, that was the key. Just make sure it doesn't get buffed. Praise the good fellow. Rest in peace. Oh god, no, there's more buffers. No, it even healed! I need to kill it. There's another one! Die, die, die. Okay. They're still buffed is the only problem. It might run out at some point, but who knows how long it's gonna take. Uh-oh. Ooh, I have one hit point left. And the buff wears off. I hate these enemies already. I hate it when there's some little squishy hanging out in the background making them 10 times as powerful. We don't have to defeat the Red Knight again, right? That's a mini-boss? I think. I hope. Fuck that place. Thank you. of toxic. I'll keep that in mind. I'm going down to where I heard that terrible bellow, aren't I? Oh! I could have jumped off up there. Nope, let's go up. Praise the hidden path. Oh, Essence Shard. Sweet. Okay. How did I used to fight those things? Bombs? Maybe they're not so hard anymore. Can I get on that over there? Oh, fuck me. Well, that's gonna be a problem. Are they coming up here, those horrible creatures? God, I'm sucking. Alright, just gotta go strong and fast, right? Now we run away strong and fast. Oh, I'm hearing those leech things underneath. Looks like it's not willing to come up here. Oh yeah, it's willing. How the fuck do I fight those? The fuck? At least before, at the beginning of the game, I had the ability to, kill them before they transformed, but here they're already transformed. The game's difficulty definitely just got kicked up a notch. Alright, let's try going this way again. Kill it super fast, don't let it buff! No! Fuck! These enemies suck. I don't just mean that I suck at fighting them, which I do, but also they just suck. Like, they're obnoxiously designed. It buffs so fast, I don't see any way I can possibly prevent it from buffing the knight, unless I go straight for it, in which case I need to get lucky and get some sort of an attack from the knight that I can dodge and then have enough time to kill the buffer. If not, like what just happened there, I can't. I have to constantly dodge. I just get interrupted if I try to kill the buffer. Unless I'm missing something? Like that. I got lucky. I didn't get a moveset that was like three or four attacks back to back. Why did I switch to my torch? Not an effective battle tactic. God, they're still hard as hell even when they're not buffed. I didn't even notice this. What's this? Ah. Don't think I'm gonna survive that fall. Alright. So, I need to wait till that knight is going the opposite direction and then run up there and kill the buffer. Oh, shit. It comes really far down. Oh, it goes all the way into the room? So I can use this opportunity to sneak behind enemy lines. Haha. Wonder how long till they come back. Oh, there's a bonfire. Time for pure luck. Well, I would say that's a pretty good place to end this episode. So, I hope you've enjoyed so far. And when I return, I'm going to continue exploring the castle.